One of the aspects which I enjoy the most in my work is the ability to connect to so many Jewish people from all aspects of life. Welcome to the Shanghai Jewish Center. 1998, my wife and I came to Shanghai to build the infrastructure for Jewish life. Baruch Hashem, today there are three Chabad houses in Shanghai. There are preschools for the children. There is Hebrew school for the older children. There are kosher facilities, there are restaurants, there are kosher shops. There's a mikveh for the women. And of course, there are three synagogues, active synagogues, where people come to pray, to learn, to study Torah, young and old. Everyone is coming here, very active Jewish life in Shanghai. Shanghai has a very rich Jewish history. From 1850 to 1950, there were thousands of Jewish people who lived here. Especially during World War II, Shanghai was a haven to tens of thousands of Jewish people. There is absolutely no anti-Semitism in Shanghai or anywhere in China. The opposite. When they hear that we are Jewish, they talk to us with admiration. They heard that the Jewish people are smart. So many Jewish people won the Nobel Prizes. And they want to know what is the secret of the Jewish people so they could learn from them and be like as smart as them. This is a very good feeling over here to walk around and say that you are Jewish and know that you're not gonna get a cold shoulder or even worse than that, but you're gonna be greeted with a smile and very warm welcome. It's very interesting that today in the local bookstores, you are able to find many books that talk about how to educate your child to be smart like the Jews, or how to educate your child the Jewish way. There are even preschools and schools that bring in some methods of how to educate your child in a Jewish way. This just shows how much they admire and appreciate the Jewish people. Shanghai is a small town of 26 million people, the size of the third of Israel. There are 2,000 Jewish people who live in Shanghai, and they are not the only ones who enjoy our facilities. There are thousands of business people who come by here every year, and they enjoy it. There are tourist people who come here, who enjoy it, tour groups or individuals, and they enjoy the variety of the Jewish services we give them. If it's the women need a mikveh, if it's the couple who needs a good meal, if they need to enjoy the Shabbat service, they're sitting together, the celebration of Judaism, that we all Jews from all aspects of life come together on Friday night to enjoy the Shabbat together. It's one of the highlights of our week. The kosher traveler will feel right at home in Shanghai, starting with our 7:15 weekday minyan, followed by breakfast. We have lunch and dinners. You can eat in or take out.
In Beit Chabad, we have all the Shabbat food, and also in the weekly, we have the kosher restaurant. Like, we also serve the people outside catering, and also for the wedding, and also bar mitzvah, brit milah, everything we can do. Sometimes we send outside the catering to the other city. יש לנו אוכל כמו אוכל של אוכל כשר, כמו אוכל סיני, אוכל יהודים, ואנחנו עושים לקופצה לאנשים טיולים. אני מקווה שאנשים אוהבים. פה בבית חב"ד בשבת באים בכל שבוע בערך 50-60 אנשים לבית חב"ד, יש פה מתפלל ולהדליק נרות, ואחרי זה יש אוכל של שבת לאנשים שאוהבים לשבת להיות פה.
Our services are for tour groups and individuals. We have the ability to facilitate both of them. One of the aspects which I enjoy the most in my work is the ability to connect to so many Jewish people from all aspects of life. We have over here students, we have over here families, we have over here older people, we have over here people who are not religious, people who are very religious, people from all aspects of life, all come here to connect to the Judaism. It is so beautiful to see it, especially on Friday night, when we get together, we sit together, we say l'chaim together, we sing together, and we see how much more united we are than what we think. If you will be here for Shabbat, we highly recommend you check the hotels near us on our website so you can enjoy Shabbat with us. There are two airports in Shanghai, the Pudong Airport and the Hongqiao Airport. Our center is near the Hongqiao Airport. It's about 15 minutes drive. And if you take the metro, it's 5 stops from the airport right to the door of the Jewish center. So it makes it very easy and convenient to get to our Chabad house. Many travelers are asking us if they are able to drink the milk in China, even if they don't keep Chalav Yisrael. The answer is that unfortunately not. The reasons why you are allowed to drink the milk in USA do not apply to China. We're not going to get into details over here, but if you want to know the details, you can ask me privately.
Shalom, shalom. Shmi Chali, ani omed po bebet Chabad 15 shana, ve ani ohev lekabe anashim me'ha yehudim me'ha kol ha'olam.